Time to meditate. You all are home. This is your time to find your real home. Being in your physical home, now you are going to find your mental home. Being your physical home more than a month, maybe your house is organized. Maybe you took lots of unnecessary things, cleaning your house, cleaning your closets, so many things in your household life you were behind. Maybe some of our friends called me and said, we cleaned our home, which is a good thing. Now I'm asking you all, being home, your physical home, more than a month, how do you feel about your mental home? If you want to find out how you feel, how you see, how you understand your mental home, this is your time. Therefore, please find a comfortable place to sit. Chair or cushion, keep your back straight, having some determination to going inward, finding your true home. Take few deep long breaths and relax your whole body. Please do it few times, relaxed and letting go. Now send your loving thoughts towards yourself, thinking, I am well, I am happy, I am peaceful. Please practice your daily loving kindness meditation. Maybe you are so used to these three words, many times, 100 times, 1,000 times, you repeat it. Every day when you repeat these three words, it is not beginning, it is not end. You just understand the loving kindness in different level. This loving kindness practice is endless. no beginning, no end, just being. I am well, I am happy, I am peaceful. You all experience loving emotion every day. Nothing wrong with that. But if you can understand this loving emotion, you can develop that loving emotion into a quality level, then it's turned into loving kindness. When you have loving emotion, you have sensitivity around it. Then you have some expectation next to it. When you have loving kindness, loving compassion, there is no expectation. It is the mental state of your mind. It is a quality. It has deep awareness. Until you understand, until you get into those higher level or mental state, if you are a beginner, keep repeating those three words: I am well, I am happy, I am peaceful. Now send your loving thoughts towards your family. May all of my family members be well, be happy, be peaceful. Think of them individually by names. Imagine their smiling faces. Even they are difficult people. In this moment, think to yourself, there is no time in my life to focus on negativities. Instead of focus on negativities, I am sending loving thoughts towards my family members for their protection, their healing, for their safety, for their well-being. They are beautiful people. I am so grateful for them. May they be well. May they be happy. May they be peaceful. Now send your loving thoughts towards whole world. May all living beings be well, be happy, be peaceful. Different people, human beings, non-human beings, people we know, people we don't know, people we can see, people we cannot see, seen, unseen. Big or small, tall or large, born and unborn, all beings, be well, be happy, be peaceful. Now slowly turn your attention to your breath. Every breath you take in, you take out is taken mindfully. Be aware of your breath. You are not forcing your breath or exaggerating your breath. Focus on your natural, ordinary breaths. You may experience two struggles during this process of meditation. One is your physical difficulties. Sitting is difficult, back pain, knee hurts, remember, meditation is not a punishment. Part of your loving kindness practice. Please learn how to respect your body, understand your limits, then change accordingly with awareness. The second struggle is struggling with your mind, with your thoughts, feelings, and emotions. Maybe you have some fake ideas. I want to keep my mind in one place. Never happen. The nature of your mind always changing. Therefore, be kind, be compassionate to your mind. And let it be its own way. Don't make any influence to it. Be kind to it. Be aware about it. Understand it. Learn from it. And let go. Again and again, each time, if you are distracted, bring your attention back to the breath or present moment. When I am sharing this beautiful message to people, I am always asking one question. Why do you meditate? Very common response, answer I receive, we want to be happy. That's why we want to meditate. Then I know so many people come to meditation, maybe come to Blue Lotus or any other centers to find that happiness. Months and years and weeks they are doing meditation. Then they go to many different teachers. Teacher to teacher, center to center, technique to technique, sitting on the cushion hours, days. Then people go for retreats, silent retreats, vipassana retreats. Some are going and become monastics temporarily or permanently, become monks or nuns. We all are in a journey searching happiness. Among those people who are searching happiness, very rarely I can see some people are truly happy. They are trying so hard, giving up all their material gains, leaving people behind, leaving their jobs, go to ascetic life, forest life. They are taking many different directions. The intention is searching happiness. I know one person go to so many meditation centers and also go to so many meditation teachers. After many years of his practice, one day he came to me and said, "My meditation doesn't work. I asked why, still I am depressed. Still I am not happy. I keep searching and searching and searching this happiness every day." Then he asked, "What is my advice?" Then I said, my quick answer, I said, "If you want to find it, stop meditating. Don't do this meditation anymore. Then you will be happy." Personally, I want to let you know, even I'm using this word happiness, that's not the best word for us to use as a meditation practitioners searching happiness. It is overused. Happiness always comes to our life with something pleasurable. We are not looking for pleasures when we are doing this journey, this practice. When we are searching happiness, we are searching happiness in people, society, communities, and also some people are searching happiness in things, materials. Those kind of happiness, even it is temporary. Why things are always changing? If things are changing, easily we get disappointed. Then later we are complaining, our meditation is not working. I am not happy, still I am unhappy. The best word you can use for this practice, this journey, the word I use, I learned this word from my wisdom teachers. The best word we can use, introspection. Introspection. Examine our own mind. Until you do examine your own mind, you never get this inner joy. The best word you can use for this inner joy, contentment. We are going to satisfy ourselves. That satisfaction we cannot compare with another person. It is unique. It has its own authenticity. Why? It is your own mental discovery, who and what we are. Therefore, I'm asking you today, doing this meditation practice, being in this process of this spiritual journey, your purpose of your journey, going inward, what I call introspection. Examine yourself. Sometimes we don't like to examine ourselves because we are so used to live in darkness. We think the way we believe or our conditioned minds, we always thinking darkness is the truth. That kind of darkness, you are so attached to that feeling, that experience, you don't see anything else. Therefore, you are comfortable with that darkness, even it is painful. What I call enjoying suffering. Even it is so painful, you all like pain. We all like suffering. We feel comfortable with it, even we are complaining about it. Why? We have something to hold on, something to complain, something to talk about. We don't want to see undistracted mind, pure and joyful, empty mind. Maybe the word empty is so negative to your culture. But empty mind is less distracted mind, less worries. It has more acceptance. Understand the truth and realities. That mind, when you are introspection, self-examination, you truly facing to your truth. Therefore, I'm suggesting for you all, every move, every step, every action you do, you involved. Every word you hear, every conversation you have, can you observe your inner self? Can you see your inner demons? Can you see your darkness? Don't hate that darkness, because darkness exists because of light. Darkness is absence of light. Therefore, be gentle with it, respect it, more observe, do your examination every day, little by little. Few days ago, I realized even a moment when I distract myself, I lose my inner joy. I lose my inner contentment. So our goal has to be not to lose even a moment of this inner discovery. Now you are so conditioned to be in that unhappy, unhealthy mental state. Are you ready to see the light? You have that ability, you have that possibility, you have that skills to see, but you have to make up your mind to see it. If you are not open to it, you never get it. If you need fresh air, just one action you need. If you need fresh air to your room, just open your windows. You will get fresh air. But the problem is your windows are tightly closed. You are comfortable to being in that dark room. You don't see anything else, any possibilities when you are shut down. So when you go more depth into your practice, closely you are watching and observing your inner self, definitely you are going to experience that inner light. Then you feel confident of your practice. Then you are keep working to find that inner light more and more. Therefore, as a meditation practice, don't addict to your cushion. Don't attach to your temple. Don't attach to the teachers. Instead of attaching to the places and people, understand dharma, truth, realities. Believe in that. Believe in your own practice or believing in your own mind, not the people, not the things. Remember this word again, your true practice is introspection, self-examination, which we call bhavana. Popular word, popular translation is meditation. Now we are going to chant for you all. Please listen to this chant mindfully and attentively. We are chanting for you all of your family members, all of your children, parents, grandparents, people who are sick. So many people call me, message me and ask in some prayers. I cannot name them all, but I am chanting. We are chanting for all of you and the whole world. Please listen to the chant and mindfully and attentively. And also we are going to do the blessing for these mala beads for you. If anybody interested, you can contact the temple.
भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा सम्बुद्धस्स नमो तस्स भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा सम्बुद्धस्स नमो तस्स भगवतो अरहतो सम्मा
සම්බුද්දස්ස ඉතිපිසෝ භගවාරං සම්මා සම්බුද්ධෝ විජ්ජාචරණ සම්පන්නෝ සුගතෝ ලෝකවිදු අනුන්තරෝ පුරිස ධම්මසාරති සංඝා දේව මනුස්සානං බුද්ධෝ භගවාති සක්කාතෝ භගවතා ධම්මෝ සම්දින්තිකෝ අකාලිකෝ හේහි පස්සිකෝ උපනයිකෝ පංචන්තං වේදිතම්බෝ විඤ්ඤෝ වීති සුපටිපන්නෝ භගවතෝ සාවක සංඝෝ උජුපටිපන්නෝ භගවතෝ සාවක සංඝෝ ඤායපටිපන්නෝ භගවතෝ සාවක සංඝෝ සාමීචිපටිපන්නෝ භගවතෝ සාවක සංඝෝ යදිදං චන්දාරි පුරිස යුගානි අන්ත පුරිස පුංගලායේස භගවතෝ සාවක සංඝෝ ආහුනයෝ පාහුනයෝ දංකිනයෝ අංජලි කරණයෝ අනුන්තරං පුඤ්ඤං කෙන්තං ලෝකං සාති තේන සච්ච වච්චේන දුක්ඛා උපසමින් තේරේතේන සච්ච වච්චේන භයාවූපසමින්තු තේරේතේන සච්ච වච්චේන රෝගාවූපසමින්තු තේයානීද භූතානි සමාගතානි බුම්මානි වායානි වන්තනින් සම්බේව භූතා සුමනා බමන්තු අතෝපි සංකංච සුමන්තු භාසිතං තස්මායි භූතානි සාමේත සම්බේමින්තං කරෝත මානුසියා භජාය දිවාතරන්තෝ ච හරන්ති ඒවනින් තස්මායි නිරන්තත අම්පනන්තා යං කිංචි වින්තං ඉදවා උරම්මා සංගේසු ආයන් රතනං පනීතං නනෝ සමන්නන්ති තථාගතේන ඉදං පිදං රතනං පනීතං ඒතේන සංචේන සුවන්ති හෝතු කයං විරාගං අමතං පනීතං යදජ්ජකාසංඛ්‍ය මුනී සමාහිතෝ නතේන ධම්මේන සමන්ති කිංචි ඉදම්පි ධම්මේ රතනං පනීතං ඒතේන සංචේන සුවන්ති හෝතු යං බුන්ද සෙන්තෝ පරිවන්නයි සුචි සමාධිමානං තරිකඤ්ඤමාවු සමාධිනාතේන සමෝන විඤ්ඤති ඉදං පිදං මේ රතනං පනීතං ඒතේන සංචේන සුවන්ති හෝතු යේ පුංගලාන්ත සතං පසංතා චන්තාරි ඒතානි යුගානි ඒදම් කිනයා සුගතස්ස සාවකායේතේ සුදින්නානි මහප්පලාන ඉදම්පි සංඝ संगे रत्नं पनीतं एतेन सन्तेन सुवान्ति होतु ये सुम्पयुन्ता मनसा दल्लेन निन्काभिनो गौतम शासनं मे ते पन्ति पन्ता अमतं विगाय्य इदम्पि संगे रत्नं पनीतं एतेन सन्तेन सुवान्ति होतु यतिन्द कीनो पटविं सितोषि चतुम्बिवादेवि असम्पकम्पि ततूपमंसं पुरिसं मदामि यो आर्य संचानि अवेन्द पंसति इदम्पि संगे रत्नं पनीतं एतेन सन्तेन सुवान्ति होतु ये आर्य संचानि विभावयन्ति गम्भीर पन्येन सुदेशितानि किञ्चापि ते वन्ति भुसप्पमन्तान् न ते भवमन्तमादियन्ति इदम्पि संगे रत्नं पनीतं एतेन सञ्चेन सुवन्ति होतु सहवस्रदर्शन संपदाय तयस्तु धम्मा जयिता भवन्ति संकाय दिन्ति विचिकिञ्चितं च शीलं पतन्मापि अदद्धि किञ्चि चतुरपाये चाभिधानानि अपाङ्गोकातुम् इदम्पि संगे रत्नं पनीतं एतेन सन्तेन सुवान्ति होतु किञ्चापि शोकं मं करोति पापकं कायेन वाचा पटिचादायपदस्वन्तायितम्पि संगे रत्नं पनीतं एतेन सन्तेन सुवान्ति होतु वनं प्रकुम्भे यथा पुंसितङ्गे विमानमासे पटमस्मिङ्गिन्ने ततोपमन्दं वरं परेशै निम्बानगामि परमङ्गिताय इदं विभुन्दे रत्नं पनीतं एतेन सञ्चेन सुवन्ति होतु वरो वरण्यो वरदो वरारो अनुन्तरोदं वरं देशैदं विभुन्दे रत्नं पनीतं एतेन सञ्चेन सुवन्ति होतु घीनं पुराणं नवन्नन्ति सम्भवन् विरक्तचिन्ता आयति के भवन्मिं ते केन बीजा अविरुल्लिच्छन्ता निम्बन्ति धीरा यतायं पदीपो idampi sangge ratanam panitam etena sanchena suvanti hotu yani bhutani samagatani bhummani vaya nivantalinke tathagatan deva manusa pujitam bundan namassam suvanti otu yani bhutani samagatani bhummani vaya nivantalinke tathagatan deva manusa pujitam dhamman namassam suvanti otu yani bhutani samagatani bhummani vaya nivantalinke tathagatan deva manusa pujitam sangam namassam suvanti otu etena sancha vanjena dukkha upasamintu te etena sancha vanjena bhaya upasamintu te etena sancha vanjena roga upasamintu te sambhiti o vivajjam tu sambharogo vinasato mate bhavam tvantarayo sukhe dikaruko bhava bhavatu sambha mangalam rankam tu sambha devata sambha bhundanu bhavena sada santi bhavam te bhavatu sambha mangalam rankantu sambha devata sambha dhammanubhavena sada santi bhavantu te bhavatu sambha mangalam rankantu sambha devata sambha sangha bhavena sada santi bhavantu te dukkham panta cha nindunka bhayam panta cha nimbaya sokam panta cha nisokam untu sambhepi panino anta santa cha manta devanaga mahiddhika punyam tam anumoditva chiram rankam tu sasanam maka santa cha bhummanta devanaga mahiddhika punyam tam anumoditva chiram rankam tu desanam maka santa cha bhummanta devanaga mahiddhika punyam tam anumoditva chiram rankam tu tvam sada
peaceful. Thank you very much. Have a good evening.